What's going on, my friends? Dustin sells with Electrician U. You guys know I'm a huge Klein fan, right? So I wanted to come out and actually see how this stuff was made. So we're gonna show you how they go from this to this. So we're about to hit the road. We've got like a 2.5 hour drive to get up there. I'm in Austin. This is in Mansfield, so it's just south of Dallas for a little bit. So I figured we would do like a vlog style thing with Dustin for the day. So when I got in there, I was thinking like, I deal with a lot of these tool companies, right? A lot of manufacturing companies and stuff in the industry. They don't want to show the machines they use to make stuff. They don't want their competitors finding out. So I kind of thought when I got there, like, they're not going to show me anything. They're not going to let me like film anything for real, because most of these companies are like that. And I was wrong. They let me film everything. Like, they have two huge buildings, which is why this is a two-part thing. But they had two huge buildings. They showed me everything and they let me film everything. I was so impressed by that. The other thing that I was kind of impressed with is my assumption going up there was that it was just gonna be assembly line, factory machines, going through the entire process for every single thing, and that there might be like a person pushing buttons for one thing, but there are people everywhere. So the cool thing with Klein is that they have a hand touch approach to everything. So they have people along all these processes, tons of people along these processes that are physically touching and hand touching each thing and adjusting and checking and, you know, verifying and then putting everything in packages. So every step of the way, there are people checking the process of all of these things. So I was really impressed by that. So now for the part you came here for, a pair of Lineman's pliers. Let's talk about the whole process from beginning to end that one of them go through. So the first thing that happens is these blanks are forged, and they call blanks like one side of a pliers and another side of a pliers. Each one of those are a blank that get put together through their process into an actual tool. The first thing that they do is they've got this really crazy expensive huge CNC machine, and they take two blanks together and they machine them as a pair. So each pair gets machined together. So once they put them through this machining process, the first thing is kind of just to like knock all the rough edges off, because they're taking really like a unusable blank that's got the general shape that they need, but they need to actually machine it into what it's going to finally look like. So they take a bunch of the excess stuff off, and then they have the pieces of these blanks that they're gonna start putting together. And then the next step is it goes to put that pin in that all of us see for the lineman's pliers. Usually on one side of the tool, if you notice, there's like a lineman on a pole. There's something that's laser etched into the side of a tool. So I always wanted to see this process, right? To see like where the pins get put in. Now they take it kind of to the next most important stage, which is hardening that steel. So they send it through a heat treating process. So there's a different process that's just for the handles. The handles need to be of a certain kind of strength, but the cutting edge on these blades needs to be a different strength. So they actually heat treat them separately, or two different processes that it goes through. But heat treating, they basically bake them in an oven at a really, really high temperature, and then they get this black charred thing on the outside of them. So when they're done with that process, the next thing is they come back, they get cleaned up. So now that we have the tool put together, it actually goes to a process where a person sits there and kind of bangs it around, opens it, closes it, make sure that everything is the way that it's supposed to be, make sure on the strippers at least that they've got this kind of punch tool that they stick into each one of them and make sure there's no extra slag or like, you know, material hanging on, and that everything was sharpened. So at this stage, this is usually a really advanced person that's been there for a really long time. They've had to go through schooling for 2 years to learn like how a Klein tool is supposed to work, you know, and you see this guy just like banging the crap out of this thing and opening and closing it, and you'd think like, maybe that's probably not that big of a deal, but they're learning how a tool is supposed to feel in your hand, specifically how Klein tools feel. And that's why we all buy Kleins, right? It's like they feel a certain way, they work a certain way, and we love that feeling. So there's somebody that is there that is touching every single one of these to make sure that they are all opening and closing and everything's all right. Then the next thing it goes through is grinding and polishing. This is kind of the finishing stage. So after they know that the tool works and opens and closes and everything is ready to go, they put a nice polished finish that we always see on a brand new pair of Lineman's pliers. And that way they can laser etch their logo into it. So after they've grinded everything and it's been polished, then they take it over to get the handles dipped in. Now, some of the Lineman's pliers out there that you see have like big handles, like the Journeyman series, you know, where there's like a blue handle with black sides and it says Klein on it, and they're a really thick kind of thing. It's just like pre-made handles that are put onto the tool. But the other style, where they have like a thin kind of almost no insulation on them at all, they're dipped. And I had no clue about that. I didn't realize. I thought the whole thing was like somebody just putting those little sleeves on the thing, but they are actually dipped in a huge vat. And depending on the tool, they have different colors for each one of the tools. So there's like a blue vat over here and a red vat over here, but they take this machine and they very slowly dip all of these handles in to this vat, and they let them sit there for a minute, and then they start raising them up really slowly, and it's drying as it's raising out of that vat. And they want to make sure if it's not drying enough when they pull it out, then there's going to be drips coming off the bottom, and they don't want that, because then they'd have to go through every single pair and like form the bottom or get that drip taken off. So they make sure that they pull everything out really, really slowly. And I guess the material's thick enough that it kind of just sticks to the tool, and then it dries. That's rad. I had no idea that they were doing that. And then after they've got everything dipped and it's all dried, the last thing that they do is shipping. So they have a whole area set up with a bunch of people. They're taking just boxes of these things, and they have packages, and they're putting together the packages, putting little inserts in them, putting the plastic together, putting a tool inside the plastic package, closing it, and then they're getting everything boxed up into bigger boxes that they can ship out. And then they're in a bay. This whole area that they're working is right where all of the trucks pull up to put everything on. So it's such an efficient process from beginning to end. And I think it's awesome. I've never realized how much people were involved in making every single one of their tools. Now, some cool things, little tidbits of information that I found out when I was there that kind of impressed me, is this one building puts out anywhere from about 25 to 27,000 units a day. That's nuts. That's so many pairs of clients. That's including, you know, strippers, wire cutters, you know, Lineman's pliers, all the different variations of like stripper Lineman's pliers that they have that are combined. But that's all. And then within that, there's about 9,000 of those that are just strippers. So about a third of what they produce a day in this one building are strippers. Everything else are just kind of like random other SKUs. Another thing that I thought was pretty rad is that these guys have been around like 164, 165 years. So they were, you know, the late 1800s, it's been family owned. There's still people there with the name Klein, you know, their last name, that are still running the company. So family owned and operated. It's just grown with our industry, with us. So I don't know. I just think it's still cool that it's like kind of small for how big it is. So that's everything for the Kleins. The strippers pretty much go through the same process. Any side cutting pliers go through, you know, same process. Each thing is a little bit different, but the methodology and how the tools flow through the line are all pretty similar. Make sure that you stay tuned for the second part of this. The next video, I'm gonna talk about how the screwdrivers are made. In that building, we got to go see things like the fish tapes being reeled up and put together and all of that. So it's actually kind of a pretty cool process to see that as well. So don't miss the next video. Make sure that you guys hit subscribe to the channel. Super helps me out. Do this for a living. Thank you so much. Also, like the video if you like the video. Hit the notification bell. Lets you know every time I have a new episode. Join the Discord server. Link below. Join the Facebook group. Link below. Follow me on that. I love you crazy people, and I'll see you in the next episode.
Discount music and video.